HIPEC is a therapy that's administered to patients with certain diseases that have spread beyond their organ of origin. That includes patients with appendix cancer, colon cancer, some patients with ovarian or uterine malignancies, patients with some gastric cancers, and mesothelioma. We select patients who we feel would have the greatest benefit from it with those diseases that I just discussed. And within that, the patients are given, brought to the operating room, and have what's called a cytoreductive surgery. What that means is all the disease that we can see in the abdomen, we remove that. So if it's from the top of your abdomen by your diaphragms, if it's on any of your internal organs, or if it's in your pelvis, we remove that. Following that, we then give the HIPEC, which is essentially heated chemotherapy up to 42 degrees Celsius for approximately 90 minutes. Once that's done, the patient then has had a complete cytoreductive surgery and HIPEC, or HIPEC for short. The HIPEC is most effective to treat first appendix cancer. Appendix cancer is rare, but those patients who have an appendix cancer are the ones who can receive the most benefit. Often, in many situations, surgeons that don't manage these patients or other physicians would recommend simply a colon resection. However, we know, those of us who treat this, that often the disease will spread beyond just the appendix. And so that's the number one group of patients we feel would benefit. After that, the next group would include patients with colon cancers that are spread, as well as some patients with mesotheliomas, and so that's a primary malignancy of the peritoneum, some patients with ovarian cancer, and in a very select few, patients with gastric cancer. And so HIPEC has a wide range of patients that could benefit from it, and it's incumbent upon physicians to refer to HIPEC specialists so we can help decide, along with the patients and their primary physicians, who would best benefit. The best candidate for HIPEC treatment is a variable question. It depends upon the disease of origin. A patient with appendix cancer often can have a higher amount of disease in their abdomen than someone would say gastric cancer with the same amount of disease. So it depends upon the disease of origin. That's number one. The second thing we as physicians that look at patients for HIPEC look at is how healthy are you. Our team at Johns Hopkins looks at patients in a multidisciplinary format to try and make sure that those patients are in the best and optimal position to undergo a cytoreductive surgery and HIPEC. So that includes making sure that their nutrition is managed well, making sure that they are in the best shape physically. And so we make sure that they have a physical therapist and do some prehab if necessary. Certainly, if patients have a high burden of disease, we work with our medical oncologists and or their medical oncologists who may have referred them to try and make sure that they undergo a chemotherapy regimen that will help bring them to an operation if one would not be an option up front. The type of physician that administers HIPEC is typically a surgeon who carries the title of a surgical oncologist. And so these are surgeons that have trained in a cancer program specifically focusing on cancer. And so those of us who do it have done extra training within our fellowships, or we have gone elsewhere into other centers that have done it more to learn the procedure of a HIPEC. So generally as a surgeon who has undergone 9 to 10 years of training to be able to administer HIPEC. The benefits of HIPEC are many. The most important one is we're trying to turn a disease that typically would carry a heavy burden or sentence to a patient and turn it into a chronic disease. And so for some patients, especially patients with appendix cancer or low-grade disease, typically when we talk about cancers, we talk about 5-year survivals. In appendix cancer, we start talking about 10-year survival. And so in those best scenarios, patients can expect within 70 to 80% of all comers to be alive at 10 years. This is something that's unheard of in typical medicine. And so these are the patients that could best benefit. In other diseases, we try to, again, convert them into a chronic state. And so these are patients that otherwise would not be offered anything but chemotherapy. and in select situations, they're able to be offered a surgery and prolong survival as well as improve quality of life.